Today.
Good. Welcome to the podcast, everybody. I'm Joel with my dad here.
We are so glad you joined us this evening.
Yeah.
Got great stuff tonight, don't we? Do we?
We do. We do. I was shocked on December 31st.
Yeah.
I thought everything was going to go away and we'd have like a reset button and then January 1st, everything would be fine. But that didn't happen.
I got a new calendar and that's all that matters to me, man. It is clean. I'm ready to start fresh, new. I threw the old one away, burned it. No record.
And COVID went away and political distress went away and everything went away with that new calendar.
It's like I tell you, Joel, there's no problem that you can't ignore long enough and it'll eventually go away. I'm telling you, man.
That is the worst philosophy ever, Dad. So I remember one time I was having a really rough series of work. It was like several months where I was the junior guy on the totem pole at work. I kept getting called into work over and over and over and over and over. And I was fried. And I remember I was like, Dad, I can't do it anymore. And I remember the advice you gave me. And I thought that's really good advice for how to get through 2021. Because I know a lot of us are thinking right now, dude, 2020 was horrible and it's not looking any better for 2021. So how do we get through 2021? I thought we'd talk about that today. The advice you gave me is kind of simple, but you said you just do it day by day. You get up in the morning, you take on that day, you go to sleep, you get up in the morning, you take on the next day. So give me your thoughts on how are we going to get through 2021?
Well, that still works. You know, I mean, you can't overwhelm yourself. We were only made to carry one day's worth of load. You know, I mean, Jesus said that. And I think of a big deal with me that I see a lot of people killing themselves with is it's what I call the principle of focus. And I'm probably not original. Not much I have is original. I just forgot who I learned it from. But it's the idea that whatever you tend to focus upon tends to become bigger in your mind. And, you know, you've probably heard me use this example. I'm sure you have, where, you know, you can block out the sun. The sun, as huge as it is, you can block it out with your little thumb if you just put your thumb right up to your eye, because whatever's closer, whatever you focus on becomes bigger. And we've got like all these promises of God, and yet we can focus on the little problems, which they aren't little. I mean, they're significant, you know, but they're not anything compared to the promises of God or compared to the sun, our thumb. And so that principle of focus, I think, is so important. And though we don't see it called that in Scripture, you really see it in Hebrews 12. It says something really important. It says, therefore, let us fix our gaze. Different translations say different things. Focus on, you know, like laser focus on Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. And then it gives us a real insight into this, who for the joy set before him despised the cross, despised the shame, endured the cross, despised the shame, and is now set down at the right hand of God. And the way I see that, it's like, okay, so here's the cross. He's on this side of the cross, but instead of looking at the cross, he, for the joy set before him, he looked on the other side of the cross. He just endured. All I got to do is get through this because there's a better day coming on the other side. And that, for him, it was an eternity. For him, it was 3 days later. For him, it was,
now,
we may not know.
He knew there was a better day coming.
Well, sure. We do too. It may not be this side of eternity.
Pull the eternity card. Suck it up till eternity.
Yeah, hold on. It'll get better. You know, sure enough. You know,
I agree with that. But we still got to get through today. And so, there's the lofty, like, you've got to fix your eyes on eternity, which gets you through. But there's also the, like, how do you get through a day?
Yeah. Well, and that, I think that's another thing. And it is so critical. Again, it's that principle of focus. But there's another passage that talks about it. And it's in Philippians. And, you know, you've probably memorized, I'm sure you have. You memorized the whole book, right?
I had to memorize the whole book in school.
I thought you did. Well, it's a powerful book. If you're looking for just some encouragement, go to Philippians. It's called the Book of Joy, because Paul was in prison when he wrote it, but it's always talks about joy and rejoicing. But anyhow, so read Philippians. But Philippians 4 says this. It says, finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise. In other words, good things, just sum it up, good stuff. Think on these things. And again, it's saying focus on the good stuff. And what I see kills people is, I mean, right now, I don't know how many Facebook messages I get that, you know, the apocalypse has arrived, zombies are eating brains out of the congressman, and, you know, Trump was evacuated to Texas, and, you know, because Mike Pence was going to shoot him or something. It's just crazy, crazy stuff. And the point is, if you focus on that stuff, even if it's true, are you going to do anything to stop it? Not really.
If there's zombies, I'm going to make sure and do something to stop it. Okay, well, they ain't coming for me.
I'm moving to Mexico because the zombies don't go to Mexico. They don't spicy food. No, they don't. Oh, okay. And so, you know, but if you focus on the true, honest, just, pure, lovely, lovely, good report, virtuous things, praiseworthy things, then those are the things that begin to occupy your mind. And you go, well, you know, we can't just be ignorant. You know, it's a difference between ignorance and it's a difference between what you feed your mind on. And so, you know, you can choose to be aware of it all and you can choose to be up on it. You can choose to be, but you're just feeding yourself anxiety. And it's going to literally, I mean, you get that stomach acid, it just eats your gut out. It really does. And so you just have to focus on the things that are true, honest, just, pure, lovely, good report, be any virtue, be any praise. Think on these things. And then you take it a day at a time. Focus on Jesus.
You mentioned earlier, Jesus said, you know, basically, he even said that Matthew 6:34, he said, don't worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Today has enough worry of its own. But what I think is fascinating about that is that's the passage right after the key passage, Matthew 6:33, which is kind of the crux of the whole message of Jesus, which was seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all the things you're worried about. He talks about you're worried about where you're gonna live, what you're gonna wear, the money, the food side of things. Seek first the kingdom of God, and all those things will be added to you. And what I think is interesting is it doesn't say like, you know, in the morning, he's basically saying, if you want to get through today, seek first the kingdom of God, and then you don't have to worry about tomorrow. But he doesn't start off by saying, seek first in the morning what your friends on Facebook are saying. Yeah. Or seek first in the morning what the talking heads on the news channel are saying. Or seek first the weather. Or seek first how you're feeling. He says, if you want the day to go well, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and then you don't have to worry about tomorrow. You can just focus on these like day tight compartments. You stay focused on today. You get up, you say, Lord, what am I supposed to do today? You do that, and then you live the next day. So, hey, I just saw Josh Anderson. I think he was just in the hospital with COVID. So, hey, Josh, good to see you online here, man.
Welcome back to the living.
Yes, man.
Yeah. You know, you mentioned that, I think you used the term day tight or something like that. You know, I spent a little time on a ship, very little, and it was an aircraft carrier, but they still had airtight compartments, and there were the doors were labeled with the priority. And if a ship was hit in battle, certain doors would be closed. So that compartment might fill with water, but the whole ship didn't go down. And that's really what, you know, I think that would be just what came to my mind when you said daytight compartments. Keep it in that compartment, you know. The rest of the world may be flooded. Tomorrow might be flooded. Yesterday might have been flooded. But if you're in a compartment that's dry, the ship's going to stay afloat, you know. And so keep it in, stay in that compartment.
That's a great analogy. They make those ships to where they can handle a lot of hits and still not sink. I mean, that's a good way too, if you're thinking about, like, you know, when you wake up in the morning and you hear the bad news, you're like, it slipped in. I didn't want to hear that bad news, you know? And you're like, my day is ruined. But if you can say, okay, let's compartmentalize it. We're starting from scratch. We're going to compartment. It's not going to sink my ship today. I'm not going to let that sink my ship. And when you do that day by day, by day, by day, by day, by day, by day.
Yeah. You have to do it day at a time.
Yeah. And then all of a sudden you come March, April, May, June, we've made it that far. And then July, and before we know it, it'll be December. And you might just be shocked. I'm expecting that I'm going to be shocked at what happens this year that's good. Because if I can keep my head in the game, like you were saying, you stay focused on the right things, keep your head in the game, don't get freaked out. And stay centered on those true, honest, worthy, good report, those things, and you'll make it through the year.
Yeah. You know, I was thinking of something else when you said, how do you take it a step at a time? And you mentioned, I think it was our friend Phil who was hiking with you, somebody who was hiking with you, and they just couldn't make it any further. And you said, I'm going to tell you tomorrow how to make it tomorrow. They were hiking Inca Trail, I think. And
that happens on pretty much every time I do the Inca Trail. Somebody's like, I can't do it anymore.
Did I ever do that? I don't think I ever did that, did I? Okay, good.
Yeah, well, you heard my mini sermonettes about it, so you didn't want to get my lack of sympathy from me.
Yeah, take a number, get in line. Yeah, so what you told him, tell him, you know, you get up tomorrow, I'm going to give you the secret to hiking the trail. And it basically was just take one step at a time. Yep. You take one step and then you take another step and you take another step. And he made it. And it's amazing what you can do. I remember coming up the Angelbright Trail, and man, we'd been, you know, hiking and carrying all of our stuff out. And yeah, it was just one step at a time, one step at a time. And it's amazing. That's all you can do.
And there's no other,
sit down, but
there's no other option.
Yeah.
Like I mean, you can't curl up in a ball.
Yeah.
That's what, yeah. Keep moving.
So like when you're on the trail there, you could just sit there and die if you want to, but that's not a good option, you know?
Right. Yeah.
And so you just keep putting one foot in front of the other, and it might hurt. You might get tired. You might need to sit down for a little while, but you make it, you do make it. And I think, and the thing is too, you know, we have the Lord with us in this, you know? And so when we honor him, it's amazing the strength that he gives us, but the internal, I mean, the strengthening the inner man to where you can, you know, you can take a balloon and whatever pressure it's got on the inside, you could put 1,000 pounds of pressure on the inside of it if you had 1,000 pounds of pressure coming on the outside. Or take a little tissue paper and whatever pressure is coming on this side, if there's equal pressure on this side, then it's not going to tear. And it's like that in our lives. We may have a tremendous pressure, but God is big enough that if we will just give it to him, trust it to him, he will come in on the other side and keep us from flying apart. That's he will good. Strengthen us in our inner man. But again, we have to count on him. We have to trust him in it all.
And you do it one day at a time. Hey, I see Greg Sanderson, Linnell, and a bunch of people. Hey, y'all, what? Thanks for watching.
Thanks for joining us. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's good stuff, Dad. I think I think we're going to make it through this year. I really do. I'm highly optimistic. I don't think this is the end.
I don't think so, because I've already bought a calendar for next year, so we can't be the end. They've already printed them. They wouldn't print them if it wasn't we were going to have another year, right?
Yeah, who would be? And why are you buying a calendar for next year?
Because I want to make sure there is one.
Focus on today, Dad. Come on,
man. That's right. I'm a planner. You know me. I'm Mr. Plan Ahead.
Oh, yeah. You are not Mr. Plan Ahead. So awesome. Well, good talk. Hey, you guys that are watching, thanks for watching. And, man, you're going to have a great year. And we're going to probably be doing this every Tuesday night at 8 o'clock. So if you want to tune in and watch these, we're trying to keep them lighthearted, upbeat, and encouraging for you. So we also have our weekly podcast, which you can get on iTunes or Spotify or all those other places. iHeartRadio.
How do they find that? So you go to Spotify. What do you look for?
Yeah, just the Malm Podcast. Super original name, MALM Podcast. It'll come up, and you'll see the one with Dad and me. It's a little yellow emblem. You can check that out. Dad's also got a website with lots of good, helpful stuff, rickmalm.com. You can check out joelmalm.com as well. So good talking to you, Dad.
Yeah, you too. God bless. Bye-bye.